My name is Stefan Houel. I'm a senior scientist at Waters Corporation. Today I'm going to talk about using feature detection to assess the biosimilarity of an innovator from Etanercept and two biosimilars. In this poster, we're going to describe the use of Progenesis QI, which is a software that is doing feature detection and quantification to assess the biosimilarity of Etanercept innovator and two biosimilars. In this work, I use a UPLC I-class coupled to a Synapg2SI HDMS. For data processing, as I said, we use Progenesis QI, and we just use charge state between 2 and 13. So for the result, on the left side, I will compare the innovator versus biosimilar 1, and on the right side, I will compare the innovator versus biosimilar 2. We have two digests, digest A and digest B. So if you look at the left panel, which is the innovator versus biosimilar 1, you see the number of features that are common, more than 98% are common between the innovator and biosimilar 1, and you have very few uniques. They represent for the innovator 0.5% and for the biosimilar 1.2%. On the other hand, if you compare the innovator versus biosimilar 2, you can already see that the number of common features is lower, like 78%. And also, the number of unique features for the innovator is higher. You have more than 13%, and you have more than 8% unique features for the biosimilar 2 and for digest A and digest B. So now if we look at the intensity of the features and look at the distribution in log 10, and this is a frequency diagram, you can see that the more or less for the innovator and biosimilar 1 or the innovator and biosimilar 2, the intensity distribution are the same. In that feature, I compare biosimilar 1 and innovator and biosimilar 2 and innovator. What we did here, we calculated the fold chance, so the fold chance will be all the time above 1. And what you can see, you have more features with a fold chance below 1.5 for biosimilar 1 than you have for biosimilar 2. On the other hand, the bottom of that graph, it's a cumulative profile of the fold change. You have a lot more features with higher fold change. So just by looking at features and comparing the intensity, you can see that you can start to see a difference between biosimilar 1 and biosimilar 2 versus the innovator. Now, on the middle panel, what we did a comparison between the innovator, biosimilar 1, and biosimilar 2. On these two Venn diagrams is digest A and digest B. What you see, you have few unique features for innovator and biosimilar 1, and you have 7% and 6%, depending on the digest, unique features for the biosimilar 2. Now, if we look at the intensity distribution of those unique features for each sample, for the innovator and biosimilar 1, they are in the low side of the normalized abundance. So those are low intensity. On the other hand, for the biosimilar 2, you have more unique features, but also they are higher intensities. And it's true for the digest A and the digest B. So we took some of those features and we did some targeted DDA, some to get some MSMS and just as a sanity check, just to be sure those were peptide. And then we were able to identify one of the peptide. And then if you look at the visualization from Progenesis QI, you have the replicate 1, replicate 2, and replicate 3. This is the innovator, biosimilar 1, and biosimilar 2. And from that visualization, you can see that that feature is just unique to biosimilar 2 and is present in each replicate. So now, so far I'm talking about features without any kind of identification. We published a paper on Etanercept with a study that we did on Cor1 glycopeptide. So we know exactly where they elute and what are their characteristics. So I extract the information, just the features corresponding to those specific glycopeptide. And from the software, when you extract those features, you can have the PCA that will be calculated right away. What we can see here, it's slightly different. So far I said innovator and biosimilar one, they look very similar. But in that case, we start to see differences between the innovator and the biosimilar 1 and the biosimilar 2. Now, if we look at a ratio between the innovator and the biosimilar 1, and here the innovator and the biosimilar 2, I calculate the ratio. So that blue line here is the ratio of 1. When the ratio is close to that line, it means there's no difference for those specific features between the innovator and the biosimilar. So you can start to see right away that you have some features that are very different. The ratio is very different. So the intensity between the innovator and the biosimilar are very different. And you actually have some of them that are very different between the innovator and the biosimilar. Now here, we can use the visualization. So those two rectangles, the red and the green, are basically the red is on the left and the green is on the right. Here you have 1, 2, 3 replicate for the innovator, the biosimilar 1, and the biosimilar 2, and normalized intensity. So you can track for A and B. You see they have exactly those features represent one of the T14 with one core. And you can see they have exactly the same profile between the innovator, the true replicate, which is what you want. And they're also very different between the innovator and the biosimilar one. And at the same idea, you can look at some specific features. So Progenesis is very good for the visualization because it's going to calculate the PCA. But now if you want to be sure that what you see to have a double check, you can extract that type of information very, very quickly. So in conclusion, the results show there is a higher degree of similarity between biosimilar 1 and innovator than with biosimilar 2 and innovator. In comparison with biosimilar 1, biosimilar 2 displays more and higher intensity unique features, suggesting there is a major difference between biosimilar 2 and innovators. Now if we look more specifically for the core 1 glycopeptide, both biosimilar 1 and biosimilar 2 show different distribution than innovator, and feature detection and quantification with Progenesis QI can be used to assess the biosimilarity. Thank you for your time.